Okay, we're going to start with the bottom of your pot. You're going to get a chunk of clay, so start out with creating a round form. The size of your bottom will dictate the size of your pot. You want it to be a complete piece, don't be adding on bit by bit. So you roll it around, get it so that it's kind of a roundish shape. It doesn't have to be a ball, it just because you're going to end up making it flat. So you use your hands to flip it. It helps bring, it makes your bottom strong. Sometimes bottoms will split if they're not, and sometimes I like to do a little this. What I'm doing is causing it to be flatter. The stronger the bottom, the stronger your piece will be. And if you can't do this part, you can always do this, where you notice I'm not going like this. I'm doing little taps. Okay, all this makes it flatter. If you look at it, it is definitely not as thick of as a finger. Here's a finger. But it's not flimsy. It won't be flimsy. So take a piece of wax paper so that you can move it. And then you're going to cut the shape of your pot. Pick it up, roll it. So it's another reason why you want to take this part off is that's usually the thinnest part of your bottom, and this makes it pretty much even. Now don't worry about it not being a perfect circle. You're not going to get one. Okay, so that's your bottom. Okay, you're going to be getting some pre-extruded pieces of clay. These are way too thick for you to make your walls of your pot. You'll notice it's really too big. So we're going to roll them so that they are longer and they are thinner. And when you do that, you're going to roll away and come back. Roll away, come back. And all you're doing is working your way down. Make sure you have the room. If you don't have the room, move your stuff around. You want to be able to do that. You work your way down your coil. Think of it like a log on the water when you're twirling it on the water. Put a little pressure on it to get it down evenly. Don't try to pinch it in position. Now, sometimes they'll get kind of floppy. This one's an example of a floppy one. So what I do is I just kind of press. And if they're floppy, that's okay. But you want them about the same size. So that's one I'll do that again. And if it's too big, you can always cut it in half like that and roll it. Okay, we're going to add coils. You've made a number of coils. So we're going to start out by scoring the edge of your piece. Adding slip. Slip is just clay that's got lots of material on it. Slip is just clay with lots of water in it. Looks a little bit like pudding. Take your first piece, press it down, and when you do it, you kind of try to create that suction that causes the clay to adhere to the pieces of clay. And then you're not going to use the slip for anything other than attaching. You don't use it to polish it or make it shiny. We're not making it shiny. We're trying to make it strong. I like to put down that last piece so it's nice and we'll sit on that. Let me go back and add more slip. Let's do it again. Press down where they overlap. Score. Okay, that's working the walls. And then you want to make sure that they are attached. Okay, that they're kind of like stacked up. They're not stacked up. They're not going to be sticking together. Okay, now I'm going to get the bottom, the interior stronger. I'm going to push down with my thumb, pushing in with my finger, but I'm not really making it smaller. You can use your tool to help it. This works good. Make sure that the bottom is touching the inside. All that goes inside, and then you smooth it out. Anything that's rough could become hard when it's cooked, and then it will cause it. Now let's try the side. Now you can go up first or down first, doesn't matter. This is going up the side. I'm just moving the clay. Notice I'm not really taking any clay off. I'm just moving it up. When I first do this, if I do it too hard, I can mangle it. That's why we don't want to have a very... Now I'm going to go back down. You're making the walls nice and strong. Make sure that's down or it's not gonna work. Okay, so that's just the first day. So if you get this much done on the first day, you're doing good. To store your piece, we need to make sure it's wet. So this is what I want you to do. Don't wrap it with this. We don't want it to stick with that. You're gonna take a couple of paper towels that are wet, and you're just going to cover it with paper towels. If the paper towel sticks to it next week, that's okay. We just want it to be able to have a little bit of a wetness, but not so much that it's going to become soupy. So there we have that. Then you're going to take one of these, and you're just gonna wrap it and wrap it until it can rest on its bottom. Use it like that. Okay, this one was just done, hasn't been on the shelf. This one is been on the shelf. So let's look and see if it's still wet. This is definitely still damp, which means I did a good job. Take the paper off, and there we have it. We're ready for the next step.